Well, good morning, good morning, good morning. This is Brother Wes coming to you once again with a word of encouragement for you, you and you. For this is truly the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. It's cold out here, waiting on my daughter to for her school bell to ring. And so before her school bell rang, I wanted to come and encourage you right quick and pray for you if I can. But what I want to say to you, what I want to say early in the morning right quick is that rest your mind and rest in Him. Rest in God. Rest in Him. And what you need to realize is that that's where your growth is at. It's in your resting. It's in your resting. Physically, mentally, emotionally. Physically, when a person is working out to get their body to look a certain way, when you're working out to build muscles, yeah, they lift the weights. They do all the tough stuff. They do all the strenuous stuff to break the muscles down. They do that. But that doesn't cause their muscles to grow. What causes their muscles to grow after they work out is the rest. It's the rest, the 48, the 72 hours where the muscles is able to repair itself. And so many of you, you've been going through trials, tribulations, you've been hit upside the head, you've been stressed out, your faith has been activated, you've been up, you've been down, you've been leveled to the ground, but you're still making it. You're still pressing your way. And so the only thing you have to do next is to rest. Rest in Him. The Bible says, God says, come unto me, all you that weary and heavy laden, and I will give you the rest. God said, those that are weary and are heavy laden, are you weary? Are you going through something? Are you discouraged? Does it feel like the weights of life, the weights of pressure is weighing you down? Are you going through a tough time? Are you feeling a difficult moment? Even David said, I had fainted. I almost gave up. My foot has well now slipped. Unless until I saw the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. In other words, he was at that place, but there was something down in his knower, in his heart, that caused him to hope again. And that was God's word, his relationship. So in this time right now, make your relationship with God strong. Make it strong. In your rest, that's where your rest is at. Your power's in your rest, because resting means, God, I surrender. Rest means I give it to you. Rest means, God, I'm gonna believe you. I ain't gonna look at the circumstance. I'm gonna trust you through the end. That's what rest is. Rest is, God, how am I doing it? What have I been doing? And it's not working. But I'm gonna do the total opposite. That's resting. Resting is getting in that Bible and say, God, God, lead me. God, teach me what to say. God, let me know what to do. God, lead me and guide me. This is rest. Rest is obedient, being obedient to Him and taking your hand off of it and let God have it. That's the rest. I'm going to pray for you right quick. Bell about to ring soon. Father God, in the name of Jesus, touch your people. Jesus' name. Give them rest. You give rest to the weary. Give them rest, God. And heavy laden, heavy hearted, you said that you would, for heaviness, the spirit of heaviness, you would give the governor praise. But in order for you to give the governor praise, those that are facing the spirit of heaviness, they got to cry out for you. They got to cry out for help. You said anywhere, whosoever shall call on your name, they shall be delivered. They shall be saved. And God, we're calling on your name. God, we're calling for change. We're tired of living in this situation. We're tired of feeling how we're feeling. God, snatch us out of this situation now. God, bring it, bring that power, bring your power. God, where there needs to be forgiveness, God, where hearts are tough, hearts are bitter, hearts are tight and hard. God, go in those hearts and go in that situation and turn it around, fix it, and make it good. In Jesus' name, God, I thank you and I bless you and I magnify you. Amen and amen. God bless you. Y'all have a good day. Have a good day and press your way. Rest in Him. Rest in Him. In other words, let go of it. Let go of it. Let God fix it. Let God make it possible. Let God fix it. See, because what God does, when there's something that's in your life that's, it seems like it's impossible, if you trust Him, He will take that I am off of that impossible. And it will become possible through Him. I can do all things through Christ Jesus that strengthens me. Be encouraged. And the reason why it's very important to study the Bible is because when you get in situations and tough situations, that Bible in you will come up. That's what happens to me when I get in whatever kind of situation it is, the Bible comes up, the word comes up. And the word in me combats against what I'm feeling. And that's why I'm able to stand. It's not me, it's God. It's God. I bring that word out. Anytime things are hitting me upside my head, I bring that word out. That word is my weapon. That word is my battle axe. That word, that's my weapon now. That's my weapon to fight. That's my weapon of war. And so let the word be your weapon of war. Use that word. When the Bible come in, when enemy come in as a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. No weapon that's formed, that's shaped, because God is in your heart, because he's buried there. And when the enemy tries to come, that word is going to come up and speak against it and remove him. Remove him, remove her, remove them, whoever it is. Amen. God bless you. Have a good morning. Coming back.